fully spent. He didn't trust his successors to be all that good at spending the ARPA budget. So most well-known Canadian artists are featured on the walls of the Bank of Canada, although most of them were not well-known at the time that Lou arranged for their purchases. But I tell you, what a legacy he left. When you do a tour of the Bank of Canada and you see the artists on the wall, it's extraordinary. Finally, just let me underline what Chuck said about Lou's contribution to the governance of Bank of Canada. The changes that he required before he would accept the position of governor and that were subsequently put in the Bank of Canada Act, they have been crucial to clarifying the bank's role as an autonomous agency operating within the framework of a democratic government. He made clear the relationship between the governor and the government. And I have to tell you, every last one of his successors have been grateful for those changes. It just made a situation so much clearer. So as you've heard, here we are, 56 years later, and we still marvel, I certainly still marvel, at how Lou Rasminsky was able to change the framework under which the Bank of Canada operates to make it a more successful and respected Canadian institution. Thanks very much.
I don't have that good a memory, but I know that during the time that you were the governor and the people that I knew that were in the bank, one of the things that resonates in me is the description that they had of you, which was that you're a real mensch, which is probably the highest satisfactory in what Lou mensch is the equivalent of satisfactory. We're working on a little bit of a deadline. The building here closes at 9. So what I would like to do now very quickly is firstly, of course, to thank Tova for arranging this. To thank me and Chuck or Dr. Charles Friedman more formally for this wonderful presentation that he made tonight. Michael and Lola for their wonderful insights into Lou, not only as governor, but Lou as the father and husband. And to Gordon Thiessen for his contribution. So thank you so much. He's all part and parcel of our getting together in the 150th year to express our gratitude for living in this wonderful country and to realize that Lou probably didn't at that time, but very clearly became a frontier person, because when you think about some of the things that happened after he left, and some were going on at the same time, the fact that we had Warren Leskin as Supreme Court Justice, Robert Kaplan and Herb Gray, and other great luminaries over the course of time, he basically broke the barrier. And after that, it was open season, and Jewish people were able to flourish and to contribute to Canada the way they had always wanted, but unfortunately were not able. So here we are tonight, and it's quite ironic, you know, money is always about currency. The currency that you have hanging over there, which had Lou's signature, doesn't even exist anymore. The dollar bill. But Lou's memory, it exists. And thanks to tonight, we will all leave with a greater appreciation of a truly great Canadian, a truly great Jewish person, whom we were all privileged to know, us from the AK generation that Michael talked about. So thank you very much for coming. It's been a pleasure. And welcome to